The first meeting I had with Michael Bay, Michael said, "Scott, I like to shoot things dirty and messy. And can we do that? Can we do that on set?" And I thought, whoa, yes, we can. That's fantastic. So we come to the point in the film where Megatron in jet form is tackling Optimus Prime, and they have to fly through a building. It's so difficult to produce great-looking, randomized, broken pieces of things, especially debris coming out of a building. So our choice here was clear. Let's build as big a miniature as possible. In this case, it was quarter scale, quite large, so large it filled our soundstage. We barely had enough room for what we call the mandrel, which is the shape of the two characters glued together. That's a green color. That races through the building, destroys the center of the building, comes out the other side. All this has to happen at about 45 miles an hour, where they only have about 15 feet to ramp up to speed before they hit the first side of the building. And they gotta hit the brakes quickly before it slams into the other side of the soundstage on the other side of the building. When we swivel the camera around and we see them land in the street, well, that's a real background plate in downtown Detroit, I believe. But the hit of the robots, of course, there are no robots. I think a couple of explosions were sent off, but you can't tear the real street up in any downtown location. So this is actually one of my favorite shots regarding the use of a simulation to make the asphalt look like it's being torn up by these big heavy robots hitting the street. It was months before we could get to the point where we could make this look pretty real. And it's fabulous because you can have a moving camera and still have the street look realistically torn up and all the pieces flying. Fabulous work.